I'm back. God, Manziel's having a pretty good season again. My Miller's having a good season. Hopkins is having a great season.
Hello?
Hello.
Hey, I'm 3 outs away from going to the World Series.
Yeah, but I'm rookie.
I'm not on rookie!
That's what they all say.
I'm literally not. Like, I'm actually not. And I was losing 2-1 to Tampa in the 7th inning of Game 7. And I put up a 6th spot in that inning to make it 7-2. And then the Rays scored a run, so it's 7-3. But I am 2 outs away with a runner on first from going to the World Series. Lewis, the Julian, the Farmer, the Minnesota Twins have won the American League pennant. In 2020, the Minnesota.
Will never happen in real life.
Have claimed the American League pennant for the first time since 1990. Carlos Correa said it's World Series or bust in 2024. And where are the Twins going to the World Series? Who will we play in the Fall Classic? Please don't be the Los Angeles Dodgers, because I know we're just going to get our butts handed to.
I think my phone charger's messed up because it's charging at a very slow rate.
You just have a slow charger?
I think so. It's because like the power doesn't really like. What's the word I'm looking for? Like if I pick up the phone, it just like. Just falls off, like it doesn't like. Stay. So I think it's the.
Oh, we're playing the Dodgers in the World Series. Oh God! And it's a rematch of the 1965 World Series.
Jesus.
The Twins and the Dodgers. That's the team's 7th of American League pennant in franchise history. Love to see it.
JJ Watt sacks Jameis Winston. Let's go.
What? I ain't gonna play it yet because I'll save this. I'm gonna eat my McDonald's.
Hopefully not into the mic.
Yum, 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 yum.
Alright, you're gonna get muted with the quickness.
I am going to watch YouTube on my PlayStation. Bye-bye!
Damn. I don't know how we give up a 37. Damn. We're getting pressure on him. We just can't get to him in time. Brian Arakpo with the tackle, let's go. 3-yard pickup.
Secondary
Brian Arakpo hits him in the backfield. I mean, hits him. And then Deontay Norman cleans him up. All right, 3rd and 5. Jadeveon Clowney almost had him. Bernard McKinney breaks the ball. Incomplete. 4th and 5. Looks like they're going to take a field goal here. And it's going to be right down the middle. So they go up 3-0. I think that was Roberto Aguayo. Could be wrong. Damn. Bills are beating the Patriots 3-0. Seahawks and Browns are still scoreless. So are the Titans and Falcons. The Dolphins beat the Colts 34-31. Hopkins picks up 20. Well, 19. One of the best receivers in the game today, if not the best. Lamar Miller only picks up a yard, if lucky. Lamar Miller, can he still didn't get the block? Didn't get the block, but Lamar Miller picks up 17. Just a yard on the play. Sean Rudolph threw a 60-yard touchdown to Julian Edelman. Corey Coleman picks up a gain of 4. 5 maybe, I'm not too sure. It's 3rd and 4. Hopkins over the middle picks up 12. And the first. Lamar Miller picks up 4. Was coming for me. I did not want that guy to hit me. The Vikings are beating the Lions 7-0. Fedorowicz touchdown. Fedorowicz gets his second touchdown of the season. And Johnny Manziel throws touchdown number 19 in 6 games. He was open wide over the middle. Great catch, great run. Perfect. Oof. Ah! I missed the field goal. Missed the extra point, I mean. That's a pretty good return, though. But we're up 6-3. 5:29 remaining in the first quarter. All capped off with a 16-yard touchdown strike to CJ Fedoritz. And now Doug Martin picks up a huge gain of four. Well, I say four.
Oh,
what's up? I'm playing, doing my Madden 17 Texans franchise right now. Playing against the Bucs with Jameis Winston. Fake. JJ Watt almost hits him, but he had Otto. Otto has to be one of the coldest white dudes to ever receive right now. That brother has like two catches or 31 yards in the first quarter. Play action fake. JJ Watt was almost there. Overthrew Mac Evans. Bamba left to go eat.
Let's go!
And we hit him 3 yards.
Chase Young is officially a New Orleans Saint.
He probably won't do much.
I think he will.
The brother can stay on the field, yeah. Maybe. Jameis Winston drops back to pass, almost gets hit by Ron Derrick Henry. And then Austin Severian Jenkins just caught that ball. I don't know how. 22 yards. Yeah, Whitney Merciless in coverage. That's probably why. Under helmet, the tackle though. Mike Evans picks up a gain of 8. The Packers are beating the Chiefs 3-0. 2nd and 2. They're gonna run it. And Doug Martin just ran over one of my corners. That is disgusting. And now they take the 10-6 lead, pending the extra point. They hit it, I believe. They do. It's 10-6. Should be 10-7, but I missed the extra point. The Titans scored. Johnny Manziel, play action fake. Throws it. Lamar Miller picks up 2. If any. 1. I lied. Johnny Manziel drops back the pass one more time. Check down. Jay Prosh gets upended but picks up 4. So now it's 3rd and 5. The Seahawks and Browns are tied 3-3. Play action fake. And Johnny Manziel gets sacked. Loss of 10.
Breaking. Raquel Rodriguez has been pulled from the internal active WWE roster. This is in result of her fight against MCAS.
change anything. They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away. I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right threat. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. It's a gain of about 3, but it's going to leave him with 3rd and still 7 yards to go.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
And he's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47.
Has a pretty good throw on the curl route there. Third down, and they pick up a first.
Defense should be aware for that, right?
They should be aware, but it was so hard sometimes.
That's not easy.
Because when they sell that route really well.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. J.J. Watt in there to get him for sack number 9 now on the year.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. The quarterback was hit.
Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. A big play that time for Tampa Bay. 47 yards.
As we continue to advance in the NFL, as people continue to scout players, they really don't care as much about body types as they care about those guys who can make people miss, run through tackles, and gain all that additional run after catch. Anybody who has that ability, they want them on their team.
8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. And here comes play number 6 on this drive.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
They'll lose a yard, and it brings up 3rd. Here's the 7th play of this drive. This is 3rd and 4.
The defense won that play so fast that I think if the running back even had time to notice if anyone was there, it was just a blink of an eye, and there was a loss on the play.
They set up the screen to Martin. Only 2 on the screen pass there, and it'll be 4th down.
They dialed up the screen pass on 3rd down, and for a second, it looked like it was all going to come together, and they had a chance to pick up a 1st down, but the defense got there and finished it off.
Yeah.
So the drive takes him inside the 10, but it ends with just 3.
And a nice job defensively to rise up and make sure they didn't get in.
This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. And now out comes Houston. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
All right, pick up 6, Lamar. Hopkins wide open. I think that was like 50 yards. Lamar Miller picks up 3. Three yards. About 2 yards. Mar Miller picks up the first. Picks up 13. Kenny Stills picks up 8. 4-9. His first catch of the game. Lamar Miller touchdown. 20th touchdown for Johnny Manziel. And we're going to tie it up 13 apiece. All right, be right back. I'm going to go take out the trash. Tampa Bay trots out there now. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy. It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember they did put points on the board. 3 points is 3 points. And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done. So the offense looking at a second and 8. Again, it's Martin. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. I thought guys that were over 30 weren't supposed to run the football this well in the National Football League. How about that veteran leadership? A big-time run combined with some nice blocking by his offensive line, showing that the ins and outs of being a veteran still has his place in this league. His odometer is not totally turned over yet. They'll run the option left. And he'll take this one up close to about the 45. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Anytime you decide to use your quarterback as a runner, most of the time when you design a play, you're expected to break a little bit bigger than this one, because when you run him on short gains, your risk reward and him taking hits, I'm not sure that's the payoff they were looking for. Winston with a give to Martin. And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down. Well, on that play, the expression, don't blink, you might miss something, certainly applied. That was fast. Defense diagnosed the play, and it was over in a heartbeat. And that's caught inside the 30. That goes for a gain of 31. There's obviously nothing shy about the guys dialing up offense here. They take a shot on third down, and boy, did they get rewarded, even though there was good defense on the play. First down, here's the run with Martin. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now, because usually you have the defense back on its heels. He's got time in the pocket, and he's going to go down. Back at the 27-yard line, he's sacked. We remind you that coming up at halftime,
halftime, we'll pay a visit to Larry Ridley in Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down.
Ready, blue lady.
Winston from the gun on third down. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Timing's crucial in any route thrown, but when you throw an out, so many things are going through the mind of the receiver. Catching the ball, timing it up with the quarterback. Are my feet going to get down inbounds? On that play, all those things going through his head might have caused him to drop it.
And Aguayo able to knock it through. And with that, they will move out in front by three. So he's been a busy man here in this first half. That's three field goals for him now.
Not just three field goals, but three for three. So even though this offense has struggled a bit putting it in the end zone, they've still been able to come away with points.
Roberto Aguayo following the made field goal, set now to kick this one away. This is taken at the three. And he will be marked down right there at the 20-yard line.
Face mask. Defense.
And the dreaded face mask penalty, that's going to cost him 15 yards.
And it's such a dangerous play. Body going one way and then... your head gets yanked back the other. 15 yards is the...
to throw now on first down. And Stills over the middle. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Out to the flat, that's complete to his running back. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. It'll be a pickup of only a yard, and it'll make it a second down. They'll drop to throw. Underneath for Miller. He had a quick little spin move, but the door shut fast as he's dropped. It's a four-yard pickup, and all of a sudden here, it's third down.
Right, I'm going to show my age here a little bit. We used to talk about running backs catching the ball as safety valves. Nowadays, they're a big part of the passing offense.
Quit acting.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Fresh set of downs here.
Cut it left.
They isolate Hopkins on the left side. On first down, he'll drop to throw. And that's caught. Did he stay in bounds, though? He did not. Ruled incomplete. So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store.
That was a nice catch, but unable to stay in bounds. And remember, it wasn't a wide receiver who works on that all the time.
I was going to say, he likes to get the ball hit.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. And now the offense operates in the red zone. And the Bucs with an extra defender in the secondary now on third down. Here's Manziel. And he's got Miller. And he will have the first down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. 7 yards on the pickup there, and now they've got it first and goal.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
Dumps it complete to Miller. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. Manziel. He's got time. And that'll be incomplete with 11 seconds remaining now.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball
and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Now Manziel. That's caught at the two. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down. So they won't get a touchdown, but here's a chance to at least get three to end the first half. So thanks to the late field goal, we are all tied up heading to intermission. As we send you cross state to Orlando to check in with Larry Ridley, he's got our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Thanks, Brandon. I'm Larry Ridley, and welcome to our EA Halftime Report. The Buccaneers secondary has held up to this point. The Texans have struggled now for two straight weeks in the passing department, and so it just hasn't been a big part of their offense. All right, let's do it. Here's a look at the first half highlights. Texans take it at the 16. Here we get a quick pass and completion, and it leads to a touchdown. They go ahead by a field goal. Second and two coming up. Martin's got it off the left side here, and he'll go in for the score. The lead grows to four. Midway through the second quarter, Hopkins wide open, able to make the grab. And he'll end up at the 30-yard line before being tackled. Continuing on the drive, Miller's by himself here. He caps off the eight-play drive with a touchdown. Texans tied up at 13. First and 10, pass will be completed out of the gun. And he'll end up picking up 23 yards on the play. Here in Orlando for the call of the second half. Let's hand it back over to Brandon and Charles. Brandon.
This is taken at the three. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. We get a glance at the Buccaneer defense.